The House of Representatives approving on third and final reading the 5.7 trillion peso proposed 2024 national budget without any changes. And this means the promised realignment of surveillance funds will be up to a small group of House leaders. The vote 296 in favor, while all three members of the Macabayan bloc voted against the measure. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. earlier certified the bill as urgent, allowing lawmakers to approve the bill on second and third readings on the same day.
I should emphasize the extensive deliberations and negotiations we undertook to pass the 2024 national budget in a timely manner. We are confident that every centavo reflects the overarching targets to usher economic transformation towards inclusivity and sustainability, and is in line with the administration's medium-term fiscal framework, the 8-point socioeconomic agenda, and the Philippine Development Plan of 2023 to 2028. Pursuing the constitutional requirement of transparency, the House of Representatives has to shepherd the national expenditure program, no matter the rigors and challenges along the way. These include the difficult discussions on the confidential and intelligent funds, which the House successfully steered toward a healthy and vibrant exchange.
For House Deputy Minority Leader Franz Castro, the approved spending plan won't address the pressing needs of the Filipino people.
Nasayang lang ang pagkakataong ito sa pagpasa ng pambansang budget para sa 2024 na halos walang pagbabago na pinanukala ng Administrasyong Marcos at walang substansyal na kaibahan sa mga budget ng mga nakaraang taon. Pinapasangan natin ngayong gabi nang walang tayong hawak na kopya na tila pinapipirmahan sa atin ng isang higit sa 5.7 trillion peso check habang nakapiring ang ating mga mata.
The Budget Department lauded the House for its passage of the 2024 General Appropriations Bill. Secretary Amina Pangandaman says the approval is a solid indication government is on track for the timely enactment of next year's national budget. She says this will pave the way for the Marcos administration to achieve its development goals. Also on Wednesday, the Office of the Vice President finally faced the scrutiny of lawmakers over its controversial budget. The Office of the Vice President, Sara Duterte, insists it broke no laws and its confidential funds were properly used for various projects. Despite this, the OVP failed to clarify how it exactly spent the budget.
We emphasize that the OVP's actions are in alignment with the law and has always been in conformity and synergy with the Constitution and co-equal branches in government.
Halimbawa, kung sa OVP, informer ang binayaran, 1,000 mahigit in cash na mga informers ang binayaran, ganun.
I cannot comment on that, Mr. Speaker, Your Honor.
Dahil
the report has
Mr.
already
Speaker.
Been submitted. Yes, the Office of the Vice President has complied with the report submission in January 17, 2023, and in April 13, 2023, and in July 13 of 2023.
The office also clarifies its 125 million peso confidential funds last year were spent in 19 days, contrary to the 11-day report of the Audit Commission. For 2024, the OVP is seeking 500 million pesos in confidential funds.
If I may also emphasize that prior to the release of this fund, plans were already laid down by the Office of the Vice President. The actual implementation was delayed because the office awaited for the release of the SARO.
Although nakuha ng Office of the Vice President yung cash starting December 13. So ibig sabihin nag-aabono na ang Office of the Vice President ng pera para sa confidential fund way before December 13 o yung na-obligate. So ibig sabihin noon kung August man yan.
That is inaccurate. Plans were laid as early as August, but the actual implementation was only after the release of the SARO in December 13, 2023.
A Philippine lawmaker gives his assurance confidential and intelligence funds of civilian agencies, including the Office of Vice President Sara Duterte and the Education Department, will be realigned to agencies that needed more. Surigao del Sur Representative Johnny Pimentel insists it was not an empty promise and their commitment will be reflected in the final version of the 2024 budget. Pimentel is one of the party leaders who pushed for the realignment of CIFs of civilian agencies amid calls to boost security in the West Philippine Sea.
There will be a reallocation of confidential funds. Of course, it will take some time, but definitely it will be reflected in the 2024 budget. Nothing yet is final, but this is the first step. But definitely, 100%, there will be a reallocation. And I said earlier, it could be a total amount that will be taken out from OVP and DepEd, or probably a portion of that amount. We want a budget that is acceptable by the people. We want a budget that is can be accepted also by the Senate. And the people have already spoken that they're complaining about this confidential intelligence fund. And that is precisely why we have this meeting. I assure you, there will be a reallocation.
Pimentel also defending budget deliberations at the lower house.
Representatives, there are about 312 or 314, were given each a copy of the 2024 budget. So how can they say na hindi po nila nakita? With regards to that it was railroaded, we were within the bounds of law. The 2024, the General Appropriations Bill of 2024 was certified as urgent by the President. Everything was above board. But, you know, no offense meant to the Makabayan Bloc, but it is their advocacy to be an opposition of any administration. So we would understand the position.
President Marcos and French counterpart Emmanuel Macron tackled the West Philippine Sea issue over the phone. Marcos thanked France for backing Manila in its maritime row with Beijing. The Philippine leader also assured Macron Manila is exerting all efforts to maintain peace and stability in the disputed waters. Also discussed during that call, the upcoming visit of a group of French ministers as part of efforts to strengthen bilateral ties between the Philippines and France. That visit is expected to happen before the end of the year.